my cup because I want this.
Good morning. Today is Saturday, June 15. We are in the 10th week in ordinary time. And today we offer this Holy Eucharist, thanksgiving to God for the manifold blessings that we receive. As we celebrate today also the birthday of Father Ken. Last night, yesterday, we celebrated the birthday of Father Salvi. So we thank for the obedience of Father Ken, who he sent to the Netherlands. We pray that he will also find his ways, can contribute to strengthen God's Carmelite families together with Father Sheldon. So in this Holy Eucharist, we also continue to ask God's guidance for the National Convention of the Third Order. May this gathering help them also reflect their roles and their challenges in this time of our history. And we pray for our biological families, for the members of the Carmelite Order, for good health and good being, and also for more vocation for the Carmelite Order. And now I invite you also to express your intentions. Together with all our intentions, we celebrate the Holy Eucharist in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Together we say, I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us now pray the Psalms in the country. As morning breaks, we sing your mercy, O Lord, and night will find us proclaiming your fidelity. It is good to give thanks to the Lord,
to make music to your name,
O Most High, to proclaim your love in the morning, and your truth in the watches of the night, on the ten-string lyre and lute, with the murmuring sound of our heart.
Your days, O Lord, that bring me back, for the work of your hands I shall be done. O Lord, how great are your works, how deep are your designs. The foolish man cannot know this, and the fool cannot understand.
Though the wicked spring up like grass,
and all who do evil try, they are doomed to be eternally destroyed. But you, Lord, are eternally on high. See how the enemies perish, all who are so evil are scattered.
immediately the wild rose swelled, you anoint me with the purest oil. My eyes look in triumph on my foes, my ears heard the melody of their foam. The jaws will flourish like the palm tree, and grow like the Lebanon cedar.
Planted in the house of the Lord, he will flourish in the courts of our God. Still bearing fruit when we are old, still full of stuff, still green, to proclaim that the Lord is just. In him, my rock, there is no wrong.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
As morning breaks, we sing of your mercy, Lord.
At night will find us proclaiming your divinity.
Paul,
the greatness of our God.
Give ear, O heavens, while I speak.
Let the earth hearken to the words of my mouth. May my instructions softly guide the way,
and my discourse permit light again.
Let the downpour upon the grass,
like a shower upon the crops.
For I will sing the Lord's renown, all proclaiming the greatness of our God. The rock, how faultless are his deeds, how right all his ways. A faithful God without deceit, how just and upright he is.
He has graciously escaped the death of his children. A perseverance and proclamation is the Lord who he has repaid by you, who has stupid and foolish people. Is he not your Father who created you? Has he not made you and established you?
Think back on the days of old, reflect on the years of age upon age. Ask your Father and he will inform you. Ask your elders and they will tell you.
When the Most High assigned the nations their inheritance, when he parcelled out the descendants of Edom, he set up the boundaries of the peoples after the number of the sons of God, when the Lord's own portion was Jacob, his hereditary share was Israel.
He found them in a wilderness, a wasteland, a howling desert. He sheltered them and cared for them, guarding them as the apple of his eyes.
As an eagle decides his nesting spot, by hovering over his brood, so he spread his wings to receive him, and bore him up on his pinions. The Lord alone was their leader. No strange God was with him.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Extol the greatness of our God.
How wonderful is your name,
O Lord, in all creation.
How great is your name, O Lord our God.
Through all earth.
Your majesty is praised above the heavens, on the lips of children and of babes. You have vowed praise to all your enemies, the silence to fall unto the Lord.
When I see the heavens, the work of your hands, the moon and the stars which you arranged, what is man that you should keep him in mind, mortal man that you care for him?
Yet you have made him blessed than a God, with glory and honor you crown him. Give him power over the works of your hand, put all things under his feet.
All of them, sheep and cattle, yes, even the savage beast, birds of the air and fish that make their way through the waters.
How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
How wonderful is your name, O Lord, in all creation.
Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call you in our need
may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah set out and came upon Elisha, son of Zephath. As he was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen, he was following the 12. Elijah went over to him and threw his cloak over him. Elisha left the oxen, ran after Elijah and said, "Please let me kiss my father and mother goodbye, and I will follow you." "Go back," Elijah answered. "Have I done anything to you?" Elisha left him and, taking the yoke of oxen, slaughtered them, used the flowing equipment for fuel to boil their flesh, and gave it to his people to eat. Then he left and followed Elijah as his attendant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, "My Lord, you are you, O Lord, my allotted portion and cup, my cup. You it is who overflows my Lord.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
I bless the Lord who consoles me. Even in the night my heart exalts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Therefore my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the nether world. Now will you suffer your faithful one to go under corruption.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Again, you have heard that it was said to the ancient ones, "You shall not make false vows, but shall perform to the Lord your vows. But I tell you, don't swear at all, neither by the heaven, for it is the throne of God, nor by the earth, for it is the footstool of his feet, nor by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. Neither shall you swear by your head, for you can't make one hair white or black. But let your yes be yes, and your no be no. Whatever is more than this is of the evil one." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have a very interesting first reading. It's the story when Elijah recruited Elisha to be his follower. So sabi ni Elijah, "Hayaan mo muna akong umuwi. Let me say goodbye to my family."
Now let me say goodbye to my father and mother, then I will follow you. So, ang ginawa ni Elisha, pag dating nila niya sa bahay, so, pinakatay niya ang kanyang mga alaga. Kasi he is a farmer. He was plowing the field with 12 oxen. So what does this represent? So ibig sabihin, he completely trusted in Elijah. At ibig sabihin, pag sumunod siya kay Elijah, he gave himself completely. Hindi yung pag mahirap doon, okay, ako dito, wala na siya yung pabalikan. So it's a complete trust and also significance that he is willing to jump into the unknown to be a follower of Christ, to be a follower of the Lord. And then in our gospel, we hear that Jesus said, "You have heard that it was said to you, ancestors, do not take a false oath, but make good to the Lord all that you vow." The purpose of an oath is to ensure that truthfulness of a statement. And swear to God, ito pa rin po ito. So, nangako tayo to emphasize that we will really fulfill what we say. Sometimes, this is very good, such as in the case of sacraments that involve making a public vow before God and the Church. In these instances, the vow is a solemn oath of inviting God's grace to strengthen it, serving as a public witness to one's faith and expression of the one's needs for God's grace to keep the promise made. However, in today's gospel, Jesus isn't addressing these solemn public vows and promises. Instead, he speaks against the practice of regularly swearing by God's name to affirm the truth of one's statements. This practice turns something sacred into something ordinary and unnecessary. There's no need to swear to God about everything one says. If someone feels the need to call on God's name frequently to convince others of their honesty, it suggests they may struggle with dishonesty. Regular oath-taking implies a tendency to lie. As Christians, we should strive for a disposition of truthfulness. Jesus says, "Let your yes mean yes, and your no mean no. Anything more is from evil one." This means we should aim to be people of true honesty and integrity. Tayo may mga Pilipino, may difficulty tayo sa pagsabi ng totoo. Ba may invitation tayo, anong usual na sagot natin? Oh, sige, tanggapin tayo, pero sa isip-isip natin, ganun talaga tayo. Punta. Siguro naya lang tayong umanggi. Sige, susunod ako. Pero hindi naman talaga susunod. So, we have difficulty of really telling what is truth in our heart. So furthermore, making frequent oaths diminishes the solemnity of the few times when it appropriate. Public vows such as marriage, vows of promises made by the priest are special and solemn. Similarly, public renewing of faith, taking an oath for public office, or other solemn occasions for oath-taking should be seen as unique. Therefore, our daily commitments should simply be the result of our honesty and integrity. So let us reflect on our approach to honesty and sincerity in daily life. Do we aim to live, speak, and seek the truth? Are we honest with others, striving for good and clear communication? So we consider these questions and understand that interior integrity requires honesty and sincerity. Let us seek this integrity in others. We will come to trust more each day. So in our prayer, we pray to you, Lord. You are the source of all truth, and you are truth itself. Please help us to be a daily instrument of that truth in all we see and we do. We choose you and your holy will always, and we choose you to be your instrument for all to see Jesus, who is the truth. Amen. Let us celebrate the kindness and wisdom of Christ. He offers his love and understanding to all men and women, especially to suffering. Let us earnestly pray to him.
Pray for us, Lord.
This morning we recall the resurrection.
And we long for the benefits of your redemption.
Grant that we bear witness to you today, Lord.
And offer acceptable gift to the Father through you.
Enable us to see your image in all men and women.
And to serve you and them.
Lord Jesus, you are the true vine, and we are the branches.
Allow us to remain in you, to bear much fruit, and to give glory to the Father.
We entrust to you, Almighty and loving God, all our prayers, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to become for us our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, to become for us our spiritual drink. Let us be God forever. Let us pray that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
In the Lord, accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for
for our good and the good of all these foundations.
Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be an acceptable oblation to you, and lead us to grow in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, and also through him, with great goodness, you form it anew. And so, it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the archangels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and you, all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving a thanks, said a blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of our faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an offering, eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and the glorious martyrs, and with all the saints in whose constant intercession In your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and his two, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
By the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
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 Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are invited to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
The body and blood of Christ.
Amen.
Lord, guide our feet into the way of peace. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel.
He has come for his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born in the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he will save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life. You, my church, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the Lord from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Lord, guide our feet into the way of peace. Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil, and lead us to what is right, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So, announcement. Pupunta pala dito si Susan. Tama yung...
Ladies and angels.
Sawa ni Junjun.
So,
we will greet them. Play with the... So Susan had been with us for a few years. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Let's go in peace to serve and love the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Nos Carmeli, vites florigera, splendor celi, vergo puerpera, singularis, mater mitis, servire messia, esto propicia sella amaris. Good morning!
Good morning!
Umaya nga po, ni Dresri. Good
morning!
Good morning!
Good morning! Good morning! Good morning!